Well, good morning all. Thank you for being here. Well, today I'm going to talk about the Foreman single sign-on and how Keycloak helped us to make it more simple. Just a few words about me. I work as a quality engineer for Satellite 6 at Red Hat. And this is the agenda for today. We will have a short introduction to the Foreman. We will see some existing Foreman authentication capabilities. We will also look into the single sign-on with the Keycloak and OpenID, what it is. And finally, we will see the Foreman and the Keycloak integration with a demo. And at last, but not least, it's question answer. So before moving ahead, let's have a quick survey. Foreman users in the house? Woo! One. Okay. Keycloak users in the house? Oh, nice. Okay. So those who are not aware about the Foreman. So Foreman is a complete lifecycle management tool. It gives system administrator power to manage your systems. You can automate your repetitive tasks. You can quickly deploy your applications. Well, the Foreman can provision your systems on the cloud or on the on-premise, or it can also provision the bare metal as well. So once the provisioning is done, you can also configure your systems using Ansible, Puppet, Chef, or SAR. And moving forward, based on the system packs, you can monitor your systems as well. So Foreman has a plugin architecture. Choose what you want. If you want Ansible, if you want Puppet, whatever it is, just pull it and make it in production. And this gives you the more flexibility on how you want your production environment. So it has huge ecosystem, starting with the Ansible, Azure, Google Cloud, VMware, OWRT, and many more. You can see the whole list here. But we are not going in detail with this. What we are going to look today is the Foreman authentication capabilities. So as we all know, user management is something repeated process across all the projects. And that's why we also have some native implementations. First is the internal users. As we know, some of the database queries and get the user and authentication from there. Next is the LDAP authentication. This includes the free API and the AD with two-factor and the OTP-based authentication. And the Kerberos-based single sign-on is also available with the existing Foreman. So just a quick look at these workflows, how it works. There is a user which goes to the browser, enters the user and password for the application. So it has internal database. Just look into the internal database. If the user exists, go inside. The next thing is the free API user login. Same window. You can log in your free API user with the same user within the free API. You can log in from the Foreman screen. Same as free API, we have the Active Directory integration as well. It just queries the database that if this user exists and this authentication, go inside. And at last but not least, if you want to have free API and the AD in the same environment, then it also you can have the free API in the trust with the Active Directory and go to the Foreman and user will get logged in. So, but the problem is we can't bind our application to particular identity provider. In this case, it's free API or AD, right? You need some application where you can do multiple things. You have some OpenID provider. You will be able to go to that OpenID provider and your user will get logged in onto this. So that's why the single sign-on came in the picture. What single sign-on does, it redirects all the things. That means you have your application. It will redirect you to the OpenID provider or whatever is your provider is, identity provider. And it will authenticate your applications. And the main purpose behind is you can have multiple applications with the single login, with the same set of credentials, users, and the passwords. And who can do the best than Keycloak? You have one application which can do multiple things for you. So what is Keycloak? Keycloak is an open source project for identity and access management. It's basically a Java app. And it supports a number of user management use cases, starting with the single sign-on. Then you have the standard protocol support, such as OpenID, SAML, OAuth. It also has the centralized management for your admins and users. It can manage the number of relevance. Also the user federation with the free API and AD. That means you have a single application which can manage your users from the whatever the infrastructure at the backend, that is free API, AD, or any OpenID provider or the SAML. Also, it has the social logins such as GitHub, Facebook, Microsoft, or any social login that you want to integrate with. So what we are going to see today is that how OpenID Connect will make you enable the authentication with your app. So OpenID Connect is a simple standard protocol for, it is based on the OAuth with the specifications, and the messages transfers are based on the JSON. It uses simple JSON web tokens. It is the internet standard, internet standard for the single sign-on. What you need to do is, it is just that you need to authenticate your user, right? It sends your user to the OpenID provider, get the identity back that is in the form of token. The token is decrypted, and based on the payloads or the claims in the token, your user will get the permissions within your app. So let's take a look on the token that provides it. So this is the JSON web token that we get from the app. And it is divided into these three parts. The first is the header, which contains your algorithm and the which type of token is it. Here it is. RS-256 is the algorithm and the type is the JWT. Next part is the payload data. This is very important because it has everything starting from your JWT token ID to the expiration and the when the token is issued, whom the token is issued from, and who signed it. So here, issuer is the ISS field that where you can see the audience, that means the client, and you will see the also number of these fields that will you get from the tokens. And the last part is the signature, which will verify your token is right or not. And coming to the back part of the payload, so payload decide who are you. That means your authentication, if you are valid user or not for that particular application. The next is what you can do. That is your groups, roles, permissions, you can say. And you don't need to register that user in your application side. In this case, it's Foreman. That means based on your token values, the user will automatically get created in your application. So we will take a look on single sign-on in the Foreman, how it is implemented and how it works. So what you need to do, you need to just register your Foreman to the Keycloak server. Just install two packages, mod.openidc and the Keycloak HTTP client. it will get, and you need to just register with this command, that is Keycloak HTTP client, where you need to provide the Keycloak URL. The next is the user, which you are going to authenticate with the Keycloak. Then next is the realm, which you are going to use. And that's it. Your application, that means Foreman will get registered to Keycloak. And the next thing you need to do to add the mappers. The first mapper is a group membership mapper, which tell you that I have this user group, like DevConf attendee, and I have these permissions. That data will get transferred to your token. And at last, you need to do some configurations in the Foreman so that Foreman can validate some things on application side. So I will have a short demo here. So what we are going to do here, we are going to just install these two packages on your Foreman server. Then we need to register that Foreman server to Keycloak. And once you register this, go to your Keycloak server. You will see a client is added in your Keycloak, in your realm. Here the realm is SSL realm, the client. Go to your client and just you need to add two mappers so that the token will return some values from your Keycloak. Here first we are going to add the audience mapper. Audience in the sense the client you have registered the Keycloak application. And the next mapper you need to add is the group membership mapper. Make sure here to token claim name should be the groups and the full path should be the disabled. Okay. Now go to Foreman server and do some settings where you need to do you need to add the client ID algorithm that you are using, the client, and some external values. So this is the authorized login delegation. You need to keep it as external so that it will create external auth source in your Foreman server. Then the ORDC algorithm, where you can find this algorithm from your well-known configurations. Each OpenID provider has some URL like well-known and the OpenID configurations like this. So you will get the value of that algorithm. Here it is RS256. Then you need to find the ORDC audience. As I said, it is the client. So put it. The next is the ORDC issuer. Copy the URL and add it as well. And finally, ORDC JWKS URL. And once you're done with all the settings, just restart your services and you're done. Going to restart the basically the HTTP service because the configurations that are created by the Keycloak HTTP client goes through the Apache. Now go to your Foreman server and it will redirect you to the Keycloak. So just authenticate your Keycloak user and you will see that user gets logged in into your Foreman application. And the values that it will get, like first name, last name, or the email address. It will come from the token that it received from this Keycloak application. And that's how it works, single sign-on in case of the Foreman and the Keycloak integration. Okay, so what Foreman does, so Foreman is responsible for number of things. It validates the token. If you are getting the particular token, if it is valid for that application or not, whether it is expired or not, or whether it is the client that is expected to cache from or not. So the next is to authorize your user based on the payloads. That means you have the number of roles and the permissions to give to that particular user. And based on the external user group, it maps your roles and the permission in the Foreman. Well, that makes it simple and more secure. As I said, your password goes to the identity provider. That means your application don't need to maintain users. You don't need to maintain the database of them. And the end application just use your, doesn't have your password as well. So that's the plus. Token has short expiry, that making it more secure. And Keycloak has a number of use cases, like you can use the smart cards, you can use social logins, or you can use your any OpenID provider or authentication protocols. And that makes it less work on the back end and making its risk of security or to reduce. Well, this is the resources. You can visit the Foreman, and if you have something cool to do with the Foreman, let us know. We also have the IRCs, hash the Foreman or the hash Foreman dev. And if you have any question, just go to the community.foreman.org. We are always there. And well, that's it. Any question? Yep.
Yes, I have one question. I saw in your video that there was a client, Nikhil, called Hammer Sign. Can you tell us about that client? Is it automatically by your utility, or did you have to create it yourself?
Okay, that was something. Okay, so the question was, in demo, I had the Hammer CLI client. So that was something different that I already created with the experiment, and that completely unrelated to the demo.
Still, that's something that's interesting because since the flow is on the browser based, but you want the CLI to be true.
Well, that was totally unrelated. I mean, something experimental. Yeah. Yeah.
So the Hammer CLI flow is also there. You could use the vertical interface flow wherein you can pass the options for an ADC parameter, like URL and name, and it'll show you what to do. And then you hope that you are comfortable and come back. So that kind of same browser and terminal workflow is also there.
If you want. That means the code grant workflow and the password grant workflow. You can have both of them. Any more questions? Well, that's it. Thank you.